Now that your file has been set up to be able to buy and sell merchandise, you now have to put your inventory on the list of items. From this moment forward, we will declare that the word merchandise and the word inventory and the word goods mean the same thing. They are the thing that you buy and sell, and I will use these words interchangeably in level 5 in each of these videos. You must be very clear about the vocabulary words that I am using when we put your merchandise and your inventory on your items list. When I say purchase cost, I am referring to the amount of money we pay when we buy the inventory. When I say sales price, I am referring to the amount the customers give us when we sell inventory. You must make a clear distinction between these words and do not use them interchangeably. Purchase cost, when we buy, will accumulate in the account inventory asset. The sales price, when we sell, will accumulate in the general ledger account called sales income that we put on the list in the previous video. There is one more thing that happens behind the scenes when we sell merchandise. When we sell merchandise, an additional thing that happens is that the purchase cost of the merchandise comes out of the inventory asset account and goes into the cost of goods sold account. Here are the two items of merchandise that we will buy and sell. We have the name, the purchase cost, and the sales price. Let's take a look at how we will add them to the items list. From the main menu, we click List, Item List. Now, of course, we go to the bottom left and we click Item, New. It's asking us what type of item this is, and of course we choose Inventory Part. Notice additional fields of information open up if it is an inventory part rather than a service item. The name of the first item will be Apples. Now, the purchase cost is $10. And the sales price is $50 of each barrel, each bushel, or each unit of apples. Notice the cost of goods sold account is already selected as the account that QuickBooks created. Whatever account you put in this field is the account that will increase by the purchase cost every time you sell the merchandise. Notice the inventory asset account that QuickBooks automatically added is already here selected as the default inventory account. Whatever account you put in this field is the account that will go up by the purchase cost when you buy the merchandise, and whatever account you put here will go down by the purchase cost when you sell the merchandise. The last piece of information to put in the field is the income account. And we know that's sales. Sales means that's the income and the sales price that the customer pays for the merchandise. When we click OK, we now have apples as an inventory part added to our items list. Let's do bananas. Item, new, inventory part. The name of the item is bananas. The purchase cost of the bananas is $20. The sales price of the each bushel or each barrel of bananas will be $100. Every time we buy bananas, inventory will go up by the purchase cost. Every time we sell bananas, inventory goes down by the purchase cost, and cost of goods sold will go up by the purchase cost of only the bananas that we sold. The sales price that comes in from the customer will go into sales income. When we click OK, we see we now have our two inventory parts on the items list, and we are now ready to buy and sell apples and bananas.